This is Wilman Ziada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. And today I am thrilled to be speaking with the acclaimed dancer and choreographer, WYNTER. But before we get to our interview with WYNTER, here is a sneak peek at her incredible talent with Special Affair. WYNTER, it is so nice to finally meet you, and I'm so excited that the audience got a little sneak peek of your incredible talent with Special Affair. And we were talking offline. I'm like, this place looks so familiar, and it's this amazing place in Queens that has so many different rooms with so many different, what I like to think of as vignettes and scenes. Talk to me a little bit about the impetus in why you created Special Affair, where you did, and how you did.
Okay, well, Special Affair was a choreography I was working on in 2020. And I decided that in 2021, I wanted to have it filmed professionally and have kind of like a visual aspect to it instead of just recording it in a studio. So a friend of mine and I got together, we planned out the outfits, the location, the date, the videographer. And actually the videographer was having a sale that day. So he said, between these dates, I'm shooting for 20% off. So I had to get it together really quick and book him for January. And I thought it was a great way to just start off the year, put myself out there and bring my choreo to life.
And not only did you bring it to life, my love, it is done so professionally. I already know with you that, you know, you're a perfectionist, but that you also almost like lean into the imperfections in that, like, you have this raw kind of relatability to your artistry, if that makes any sense whatsoever. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but maybe you can help me out and be like, okay, Will, you're crazy, or okay, Will, you're right.
Definitely right. I'm very much so a perfectionist. I'm very specific on whatever it is that I put out there because I want it to represent me in the best way. So even with that visual, I remember after the videographer sent me the finished product, I wrote him back and I said, there are little things here and there that I kind of want to tweak. Maybe I should just reshoot the whole thing. And he was like, are you kidding? It looks great.
So, yeah. Oh my God. I love it. Literally, I'm watching it and with my director hat, I'm like, I know she's a perfectionist, but good. I literally was watching. I'm like, good for her. She let that stay in because again, it was so effing real. I love that. Okay. That I'm not as crazy as, well, I know I am, but anyway, listen, I want to know for, WYNTER, you are such an immense talent. I'm curious because I love asking artists this because I was a singer for 20 years before I became a director, which is truly my bliss. But I'm curious, you know, because you still consider yourself both a dancer and a choreographer, but in transitioning to also becoming a choreographer, how did that journey come about for you? Was it an aha moment? Did you love, like, what was it about choreography that drew you to it?
Mm-hmm. Well, with choreography, I've been taking classes for about most of my life, and I just wanted to try and put the moves together myself because, I feel like certain moves, I know what works well with my body, and I just wanted to be able to choreograph something that worked really well for my body. So, and I also had other friends who were in that field as well, who I took class with, and they started teaching their classes. And I was like, wow, they're successful doing this. Maybe I should start, you know, trying it out. And yeah, and just creating. Usually when I listen to music, I have like a whole vision in my head of what's happening, kind of like a movie playing.
Okay. You literally are looking at my next question, because I'm going to tell you something with my gut. You are not only a dancer and a choreographer, but you also do have a director's brain. You have a cinematography kind of brain that, even though you're probably making dance for, you know, like a three-dimensional, you know, proscenium, whatever, you do see a natural 360, and it comes across in your videos.
Oh, thank you.
I'm from New York. I don't BS.
Thank you. Yeah, I usually see a whole picture when I'm trying to put something together, not just the steps.
You're a storyteller. You probably come up with the freaking story. You probably see like a boy and a girl. You're like, okay, and this is what's going to happen first. And then this is how the arc of that. Like, you're a storyteller.
Yes, definitely. And it's difficult sometimes to get those stories out of your mind onto like paper and like creating it visually, like relating that to the other person who's helping you bring it to life, which is why the videographer that I work with that shot Special Affair, I love working with him. I want to do all of my future projects with him, because I feel like he really gets the vision.
Listen, you probably know now more than ever, as I'm kind of slowly going into the film and TV world, that DP, that director of photography, my goodness, once you land someone who gets and understands your language, and also it's a shorthand, it's a special relationship. So that's amazing that you found a DP that you trust and also who gets your vision.
Yes, definitely. And I don't know if it's because, I don't know if you're into zodiacs, we're the same sign. I'm Aquarius, he's Aquarius, so I feel like he gets it.
Wait, when's your birthday?
January 21st.
My sister's January 19th. No wonder I liked you.
She's right on the cusp. I think Aquarius starts on the 20th.
Oh, shoot, really?
Yeah, that's the Capricorn's cusp.
Oh.
Yeah.
I won't tell her. You just have like, you literally have this like such a sweet essence about you, but you also have this like silent killer about you. Like, you're sweet, but you get ish done, but you do it with a smile. Am I kind of right?
Yes, you're smart.
You're welcome. Okay. Anyway, I'm November 23rd. I think that's Sagittarius.
Yeah, I think that's a Sag.
What am I? What does that mean? I don't know anything about signs.
I think that means you love to travel. You're about your business. And I don't know. I mostly know like female Sagittariuses.
Uh-oh.
They're intelligent. They love travel.
Okay. Like, God bless America. I'm gonna research more about it. In the meantime, talk to me a little bit about Whiplash.
Okay, so Whiplash is the brand that I started. I actually started it in 2019, the end of 2019, and I carried it on into 2020 when the whole pandemic hit. I was working with a business partner at the time, and we opened up a dance studio, and I started teaching classes out of that studio. We renovated the basement to be a studio. Yeah, it was a small space, but it was great starting out, and yeah, I would just teach there. I would teach there weekly and just kind of see how people responded to my choreo. I was very nervous when I started. I was like, are people going to come to class?
Well, of course. I think starting any venture. But my love, you're a mogul. You're a badass business. Like, you have, when I think of Winter, I think of a Renaissance woman. And I love that you unapologetically are going after everything that feels right, but it's also still a part of the brand that is Winter. Do you know what I mean? Whether it's your classes, whether it's your dancing, your choreography, the films that you are going to make, films, not just music, the films, everything is of the brand of Winter. And for me as a viewer, but also with my director hat literally on, you're about empowerment and unapologetic living in your power and authenticity. And you know what? I think about my niece. I think about the young Winters out there who now have someone that they can look up to, who is an unapologetic badass. Sorry, that was my soapbox. I've been waiting all week to tell you.
Aw, thank you. I really appreciate that. It's great to, you know, be recognized for the hard work that you put in, because there's a lot that goes in behind the scenes that people don't see. They probably just see the outward.
They see the filter. They see the selfie. They see the finished product. They don't see the schlep, the blood, the sweat, the tears.
Yes. Yes, exactly. But that's all I ever want, is for my work to reach other people and for it to be appreciated and bring my story to life.
Well, Winter, listen, I could speak with you all day. I want to let our audience know, for more on the incredible Winter, you can read more about her right below this video. And I'm also so excited you're coming on board this new app. And, you know, with all that you have going on and the over 600 artists, Winter, I've already gotten to speak with all around the world. You have a transcendent universal language and quality to your work that I can't wait for the world to see.
Thank you. Yes, manifesting.
That baby, it's on my vision board for you.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Have a good one.
Thank you, same to you.